Okay, let's do this thing. iPhone 11 event happened this morning, and it was a long event. It was like 2 hours or something. I guess that's the same length as it usually is, but it felt like a long time. But yeah, let's talk about it in less than 2 hours. This video is brought to you by Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, business, and more. Right now, I'm going through Gary Vaynerchuk's Context is Key, Social Media Strategy in a Noisy Online World. You can always know more and get better, and Gary V really knows his stuff. Prior to that, I went through Thomas Frank's Productivity Masterclass, Create a Custom System That Works. Skillshare offers classes on graphic design, film editing, music production, and a ton more. Whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or career, join more than 7 million creators learning with Skillshare. Take advantage of this special offer for Painfully Honest Tech viewers. Skillshare is giving away a free 2-month unlimited access. Just click the link in the description box and get 2 free months of learning courtesy of Skillshare and Painfully Honest Tech. Hey there, friends on YouTube. My name is Jason, sometimes known as the JTL. This is Painfully Honest Tech. Tech so honest it hurts. If this is your first time here and you want to come on back again, then like, subscribe, bell, notify yourself with that icon, and you will be here for all the Apple coverage and other technology-related coverages that I provide here on the Painfully Honest Tech channel. And if you've been here before, thank you so much for coming back again. I really do appreciate it. If you have it within your heart and ability to join the channel and come be a part of our community, then hit that join button down below and you can find out all about what you get when you do. Let's just go through things as quickly as possible. I'll give you some ideas about how I felt about it as we go through, and then like kind of a bigger picture idea as we finish up. The first thing they came out with was Apple Arcade, which looks like it could be cool. $4.99 a month is the big news here. $4.99 a month. The games look pretty good. That $4.99 is good for your entire family to play, and you get to play any game on the arcade for that $4.99. It remains to be seen whether or not any of the games are good, but they did have Frogger, although it wasn't like classic Frogger. It was some different kind of Frogger, but it was still Frogger. So, Apple Arcade looking good. They next segued over to Apple TV Plus. This was something that we were curious about too, because they have Apple TV Plus. We haven't heard like what's it going to cost, blah, blah, blah. When's it going to happen? All that kind of stuff. And so what we found out was, we got to look at a Jason Momoa show called C that is like sort of a dark sci-fi set in the distant future, but everybody's like back to living as sort of like cave people. I don't know, but I like that kind of show. I like the dark sci-fi, and so I'm definitely interested in checking it out. And I guess the big thing about this announcement was it was $4.99 a month. I was really afraid that Apple had planned on putting it out there for something like $20 a month or $25 a month, and nobody was ever going to go for that, especially after Disney announced Disney Plus at $7.99. So Apple came through for $4.99 a month. You get everything that Apple TV Plus offers, and you get that for your whole family. And if you buy an Apple product between now and when the service goes live in November 1, it's also my mom's birthday. Happy birthday, Mom. Then you will get 1 year of Apple TV Plus for free. So if you're going to get a new iPhone, so if you're going to get one of these new iPads that they talked about, if you're going to get anything like that, you're going to get an Apple TV, 1 year of Apple TV Plus for free. Now, that's good thinking, because Apple was really going to have to draw some eyeballs toward their service. It's all original content, so there's not really any established properties that are going to draw people over. So this is good. This is good. With this, they might have a fighting chance to have a viewership. Next, they went on to talk about iPad, and they were really only talking about one iPad, and that is what they call the iPad, the cheap one, the one that I got a couple of months ago for $249 or something like that. This is a new one. It's iPad 7. It's got a 10.2-inch screen, which is, if my math is correct, 0.5 inches larger than the 9.7-inch screen of the current one. It's got a A10 Fusion chip in there. I don't know. Fusion, none of it means anything. Yeah, and it's got the pogo pins on the back so you can use the smart keyboard. It's got improved pencil support, all that kind of stuff. This is one of the best deals in tech. Honestly, the iPad cheap is one of the best deals in tech, and it's just about as much iPad as the majority of people need. So you don't have to go out and spend $500 to $1,000 on an iPad when you don't need that much iPad. You got this one, and now they made it better, so I guess that's a win. They moved on then to Apple Watch Series 5, which the bullet points that you need to be aware of here, they got titanium, they got ceramic, and in terms of build materials, it has an always-on display now, so instead of like not being able to see your watch when it's just when you're just sitting there and doing this, then you can see it. And supposedly they've done something with the chip and the screen that makes it so that it's ultra low power, so it won't drain your battery, and even though the screen is always on, you will still have the same battery life as the current Apple Watch. Now, that's not always great battery life, but it's good enough, it gets you through a day. So that's what the Apple Watch Series 5 is offering. The GPS version is going to be $399. The cellular version is going to be $499. And they're still going to offer the Series 3 Apple Watch for $199. And again, I think that this is one of the biggest things to take away from this event, is that Apple lowered the prices on a bunch of things, and it's going to put those things within reach of a lot more people. They moved on then to the iPhone 11. And they did it weird. First, they started out talking about the iPhone 11, which is really the replacement for the iPhone XR. They've got new colors. They've got lavender, green. They've got pink. They got white. They got black. They got product red. And unfortunately, all of those colors are way too, well, I mean, white and black and red are white and black and red. But it looks a little lighter than this red. But the pink, the lavender, too pastel-y. Oh, there's a yellow, too. But they're all too pastel-y for my taste. I don't see myself being interested in the iPhone 11 this year because it just doesn't have a color scheme that I'm interested in. They didn't really talk too much about the liquid retina display. I assume it's going to be, but there was talk that it would be 1080p this time. They did not say whether it was 1080p. At least maybe I missed it. But if I did, let me know in the comments down below. But it's still a lower resolution screen than the higher end iPhones. And the debate goes on about whether or not that matters. I in my experience with the XR, I don't really see that big a difference, especially if I'm not, you know, pixel peeping one phone against the other. The biggest news about the iPhone 11, of course, was the camera stuff. The iPhone XR has one camera lens, and the iPhone 11 has two. I assumed, and maybe this was wrongly so, I assumed that there would be a telephoto and a wide-angle lens, but no. They went with wide angle and ultra wide angle. You can use both lenses in concert. You can take pictures with, you can take a picture and have both as an option for usage. That is really cool. That is something that I haven't seen in other camera apps. Maybe I'm wrong. You let me know. Of course you will. They also now have pet portrait mode. So for those of you who've been bummed out that you can't take pictures of your pet in portrait mode on the iPhone XR, now you got the iPhone 11 and you can do it to your heart's content. And I'm not making fun. I like taking pictures of my pets. So yeah, whatever brings you joy. They showed off a night mode feature that looks like it works really, really well. They showed a picture without the night mode, and then they showed the same picture with the night mode, and it was night and day. Pardon the pun. But we won't really know if it's better than other night modes or if it compares with other night modes until we get the phone in our hand and we get it another phone in our hand and we take night mode pictures and see which one is better to our eyeballs, which is, of course, subjective to a certain point. So, yeah, camera comparisons are not really really useful. That's for you, the rest of YouTube tech world. They also introduced slow fees. They're calling them slow fees, which somewhat clever, but not clever enough to really get me to ever say slow fees again after talking about this phone. So yeah, they got slow fees. Those are slow motion selfies. Slow motion selfies, which could be so gimmicky that nobody will ever use it, but it could also be really cool. I don't know. I can't picture a moment in which I would be needing to take a slow-mo selfie, but maybe you have an idea and you can let me know down in the comments, because I can't see myself ever wanting to do that. They also announced that the battery life on the iPhone 11 will be 1 hour better in terms of length than the iPhone XR. And the iPhone XR was already like a battery champion. So you get an extra hour with the iPhone 11. That's maybe a reason to think about purchasing it just right there. Because I tell you what, the battery in the iPhone XR has been amazing. It's amazing. It was kind of strange. They brought out the iPhone 11 and they didn't say anything about the other iPhones, and then maybe making it seem like there wasn't going to be any other iPhones. But of course there were. The iPhone 11 Pro and the iPhone 11 Pro Max. Yes, they went there. I guess we just have to deal with it. The takeaways from this, the midnight green color that they showed off looks really, really good. It looks better than all the other colors, in my opinion. And so I think I'm going to be getting a midnight green version of one of those two phones because, yeah, it looks nice. They also said that the screen is much better. Or something best that they put in an iPhone to this date, which of course it would be, because why would you put a worse screen in? I don't know. They're now calling it Super Retina Display. Now, if you think back to the old days, Retina Display meant it was calibrated with the number of pixels that you needed to look at the screen and not see any pixels. So that was what Retina meant. You didn't see pixels. And now Super Retina, I don't know what that means, but it's something that they're just putting adjectives on things now. They're just putting adjectives on things, and it doesn't really matter if it means anything. It's Super Retina because it's better than Retina, which is whatever. The camera on this phone has one more lens. It does have that telephoto, which gives it the three lenses, which makes it look kind of bug-eyed and all that kind of stuff. But again, the stuff that they're doing with these cameras was really impressive. It's impossible to tell by watching a presentation what it's really going to be like. But one of my dreams, one of my hopes for the iPhone 11 was that with this new camera module that is so ugly, they would at least bring the camera game up to, if not beyond, what everybody else is doing. Now, they didn't make any comparisons to any other manufacturers. They didn't do anything like that. However, the camera stuff has the potential to be really good. That's really all there is to talk about when it comes to the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, 11 Pro Max. You got a new finish on the back of the Pro models. I think it might be on the 11, but they didn't say. It's a matte finish on the glass, which looks really classy. But as iPhones go, this is exactly what we thought it was going to be. It's a iterative update that, you know, has a couple of new bells and whistles, but nothing that's going to really say, I must have this phone. Which reminds me, pricing-wise, we are starting the iPhone 11 Pro at $999, just like the last year's models, and the iPhone 11 Pro Max at $1099. So that's the same. They're keeping the XR at $599, they're keeping the iPhone 8s starting at $449, and the 11 starts at $699, which is a huge deal for me, because all last year I was complaining that the XR, it would have made a lot more sense in the price point that it was sort of sitting in if it was $699 instead of $749. Overall, the event was what we thought it would be. We've got the iPhone 11 models with the new camera. They've got some other improvements. We got the watch, we got the iPad, we got the services in terms of arcade and TV Plus. We didn't get the pucks that suddenly came out last night as like a possibility. We also didn't get, on any of these phones, reverse wireless charging. And all the way up to last night, everybody thought reverse wireless charging was coming, but they didn't say it was here, so I guess it is not. And honestly, folks, that is fine. Reverse wireless charging is a cool trick, but to get that reverse wireless charging going, you're really putting a lot of strain on your battery, and that's really it. Let me know down in the comments if I forgot anything. I walked away from the event just kind of, it was interesting, but I think the days of watching an Apple event and just being gobsmacked by how cool everything is are gone. Those days are gone. Maybe next year it's always maybe next year, but they're gonna do a whole new redesign of the phone, etc., etc. But these events at this point have become pretty mundane, and this one was pretty mundane. So I'm excited for some of the stuff that they announced. Some of the stuff that they didn't announce is a little disappointing. Some stuff, the way that they talk about things, is always just really frustrating. But we made it through. The iPhone 11, 11 Pro, 11 Pro Max, it's going to be hard to learn how to say that, have been unveiled to the world. They're going to be available on September 20th, along with the watch on September 20th. I can't wait to get one in my hands so I can really start talking about what that thing is and is not. Thanks so much for being here. I really do appreciate it. If you've liked this video and you wanna let me know that you've liked it, you can hit the like button. If you've never been here before, you want to come on back again, then subscribe, bell, notify yourself. If you've been here before and you came back again, thank you so much. It means the world to me. I do have that membership offer down in the description below, right below the video. And so that is it. Once again, my name is Jason. This is Painfully Honest Tech. Tech, so honest, it hurts. Until the next time. I'm out.